Focusing on this year's Breastfeeding Week theme, let's make breastfeeding and work work. An action to help working mothers to get time for their babies. Dr. Samali Namkosei, the Assistant Commissioner in Charge of Nutrition at the Ministry of Health, says many working mothers do not get enough time for their babies.
Only 78% of the mothers initiate breastfeeding within the first hour after delivery. And when we look at also our statistics, 63% of the mothers exclusively breastfeed. Our target would have loved every woman actually to breastfeed their infants for the first 6 months of life and continue breastfeeding. But we have challenges around this.
According to Dr. Namkosei, the health and gender ministries are working hand in hand to ensure that at least working mothers can get 6 months of leave from the initial 3 months.
The working mothers are entitled for maternity leave of 60 working days. This is equivalent to 3 months, but this is not sufficient. So we encourage these mothers actually to bring their babies to the working places. And that's why this year we are really emphasizing that the working places should have at least breastfeeding corners where these mothers can go and breastfeed their babies and then get back to work.
Working mothers face many challenges and need support to maintain breastfeeding. Many are not able to breastfeed on time because of the nature of their work. Dr. Nangonzi Razia, the head of maternity at IHK, explains how failure to breastfeed on time affects both the baby and the mother.
Long without breastfeeding, milk stays in the breast. And then because it's not moving out, it attracts infections, and the condition is called mastitis. The breast feels hot, heavy, and painful. Unless when it is expressed out and mother has started on antibiotics, otherwise it can become another complication that can lead to other medical interventions. Before mastitis comes in, there is an engorgement that mother gets. Is the feel, the breast becomes full, hot, and painful.
She further explains on how a working mother can breastfeed their baby while working to avoid infections on both the mother and the baby's side.
I have enough breast milk even when I'm staying home. I should express and store this milk in the fridge if I do have a fridge. And how do we store this milk? First of all, before you start expressing the breast milk, you have to make sure that you're clean, your hands are clean. Bottles that you're going to use or the milk bags that you're going to use are clean. We should avoid storing milk in anything that is dirty. We should stop storing milk in polythene bags. We should avoid storing milk in cups because they are not safe enough to maintain our.
Us who don't have freezers, who don't have fridges at home, what we usually tell them to pump, keep in the water, cold water. Then, because sometimes cold water is like a fridge, you get it from the cold water, you put it in hot water, you warm it.
To the many mothers who don't have enough breast milk, nutritionists from the Ministry of Health recommend foods that mothers can eat during and after pregnancy to boost their milk production.
Breast milk is as a result of what the mother eats and the wellness of a mother. So if a mother is feeding well on all the food classes, if a mother is rehydrating, we know breast milk is almost 90% water. So mothers should definitely be rehydrating throughout the whole day. And every adult is expected to have at least 3 meals a day. So if a mother is breastfeeding, the least they can have is have 3 meals per day.
Exclusive breastfeeding for the first 6 months is very effective in preventing infant morbidity and mortality. However, 36% of Ugandan children below 6 months are not breastfed exclusively, despite its active promotion. In Uganda, many working mothers stop breastfeeding before the end of the mandatory maternity leave of 60 days. Report compiled by John Musenze for the news.